Hello guys, in this video we will watch a game of the best Korean Camille in the world. She has insane 70% win rate in Grandmaster of Korea. It's insane number. So, if you wanna know the true power of Camille, you should watch the video to the end. And now, let's go! This Camille will play on top on lane against Gwen. Oh, this Gwen has very strange summon spells. Look at this exhaust teleport. Why she got exhaust? It's pretty strange. And also this Camille got teleport with ignite. For Camille it's good choice. Oh, she don't need flash, she has her E. And with ignite you can try to win lane. And with teleport you can try to help for your team. So it's good choice, but for Gwen, exhaust. Maybe it's good for against Camille, cause Camille is very fast champion, and maybe she trying to catch this with exhaust. And look at this, they're trying to fight at level 1, but this Gwen lost the fight. It was not good trade, cause Gwen, she tried to trade in the creep wave and she got some damage from creeps. Also this Camille, she activated her passive, so it blocks some damage. Oh, look at this, this very insane numbers. And Gwen played not good, so now Camille got first blood and she got additional Doran Blade. So it's very huge power spike from her, but it's not enough. Cozy just one kill, just one Doran Blade. And she still can try to lose this lane. But Gwen, she is weak in early game. She can try to poke you with her Q. And she is strong at level 1, but at level 3, I think Camille is much stronger than Gwen. And look at this. This difference between Gwen and Camille. Like I said, at level 3, Camille much stronger than Gwen. And now she got another kill on this Gwen. So it was so good play. And this is what means the best Korean Camille. She got 2 kills, she will farm these creeps. And she'll get huge advantage against Gwen. So it will be very good. But Gwen, this is late game champion, so maybe she can try to come back to the lane. Also, her homepage you can see below. Conqueror, Triumph, Legend Alacrity, Last Stand, Magic Footwear, Biscuit Delivery, Attack Damage, and Magic Resistance. This homepage against Gwen. And in this time, Lee Sin tried to kill this Galio, but Galio is pretty fat, so it's very hard to kill this champion. And now our Camille got Sheen. So it means she'll deal so much damage with her Q. And I wanna see that. This Gwen stacked her Q stacks. And this lane will slow push to the Camille. So this Camille tried to trade with this Gwen. But this Gwen playing now very safe. And it's good. Gwen trying to poke this Camille, but she has very good sustain and this shield. And now she trying to fight against Gwen, and Gwen just lost this fight again. This is cause Ignite has cooldown 3 minutes and this is much longer on 30 seconds, this exhaust. So Camille just knew that, and she just jumped in on this Gwen, and she won this duel. So this is another difference between exhaust and ignite on the lane. Exhaust, this is choice more for late game, cause it's very good, works in late game. You reduce a lot of damage from enemies and move speed for 3 seconds, but in early game, ignite much stronger than exhaust. So if you wanna win lane, you should get ignite instead of exhaust. So now this Emil now got 3 kills, but you don't wanna fight against this Gwen right now cause there was so much creeps and she just farming.
Patience isn't a virtue, it is the virtue.
This Gwen still level 5 and she playing very strange. Why you just coming for no reason? Oh, there was Hikarim, but there also was Lucina, and this play from Camille was pretty good. And oh, and now she made double kill. And also this Galio, she trying to kill this Galio, but he survived on a few HP, man. Oh my god, man, this is 20 HP. He survived on 20 HP and he made double kill. But he was so close to die. And it would be triple kill for the Camille. But this damage was not enough and he survived. But guys, it was so unlucky play, but it was beautiful play from Camille. And now this Camille got 5 kills, guys. 5 kills. This Gwen can't do anything. Even with ultimate. She trying to do something against Akali, but Gwen is weak in early game and you are not assassin to kill this Akali. She just used her E, W and she escaped from this Gwen. And our Camille now trying to farm and maybe she wanna get some plate. That will be very good for her. Now also she got this page. Additional damage, sustain, health. But Gwen was there, she's level 6, lol. And this Camille, she trying to poke this Gwen even under her tower. Cause she has sustain on her Doran Blade and page. So she can allow herself to trade under enemy under enemy tower. But this Gwen, he was pretty fat. So you can't one shot her. You just need to poke her before you try to kill her. And I think now this Gwen won't fight in all in trades against Camille. Also Camille has ultimate, so maybe she can try to fight against this Gwen. This Gwen lost her W, so now she without additional resistance, but there was Hikarim. He tried to kill this Camille, and now this Camille, she's her ultimate ignite on this Hikarim, and Gwen also died. This play from Camille. She played very aggressive, so risky, but she got double kill, man. I would just went back, but she's her ultimate, ignite double. She made her hit and she got shield from this passive. So it was really so huge play from her. And now this risk was worth and she got double kill. And also this Gwen used her teleport to kill this Lucina, but man, you just Gwen, but this Gwen did very good damage to enemies, but was not enough to kill Akali. And this Akali survived with her flash through wall, and this Hikarim hasn't any mobility to kill this Akali, and this Akali just survived, so it's additional kill for Camille. No, this Camille got 7 kills to assist, so it's really insane. And it's really, guys, now she'll push this lane and maybe she can try to get some play. Enemy Gwen so behind, she's 0-6-2. Oh, this tower shots. Ow! Oh! Oh my god, man! She got so much this tower shots. But she finally got played. And maybe she'll buy next item. I think she'll buy Divine Thunderer. It's new broken item for Camille. But Santa in this patch works very well. So she have to buy it. Yeah, she got Divine Sunderer, also Mercs, and she using teleport to the top of lane against this Gwen. And maybe she'll try to freeze this lane. Yeah, she'll try to freeze lane. Or maybe slow push. No, she don't wanna freeze lane. Or reveal. Oh, that was smart. Enemy Hikarim still missing. They can try to gank this Camille, because she has good streak. But Gwen was on middle lane. They still trying to gank this Akali, but it's very hard to gank Akali, guys, it's so bad. Because E, W, so in flash, but flash on cooldown, but anyway. Her E works like flash. Also, she can use her ultimate. And this broken W on Akali. So it's ungankable champion. And it's a bad target to babysit. Better to babysit top lane or bottom lane. But this Camille is got so much gold. And now she got another blade. And also she activated her Q on this Gwen. This skin on Gwen looks so cool. Oh, this damage was very well. But this Gwen still is pretty fat. Camille has that this strong one-shot damage to kill this Gwen under her tower. So first we just need to poke her. Also enemy bot lane, they use hero on bottom lane and they got so much plates. But Fortuna defended this tower with her ultimate. So it's good. And enemy still trying to do something. They got 4 kills. Galio with Hikarim trying to do something. So enemy has very good potential. Also in late game enemy much stronger. Gwen in late game with Kog'Maw and Lulu. It's guys broken machines. Gwen can with Kog'Maw play literally 1v5. So in late game they very strong. And for Camille, the best way to go to end this game as fast as you can. But now with disadvantage, she got 7 kills. I think she can to end this game. Oh, this Gwen, she's so low, maybe you should jump on her. She don't flash, but she has exhaust. So this Camille don't wanna jump. Maybe also, yeah. Akali pinged that Galio missing, so maybe enemy Galio trying to fight on this Gwen. Now he at middle lane, but maybe if this Camille would jump on Gwen, she would use her exhaust and this Galio would use his ultimate on Camille. And Camille without flash will die. And also enemy Hikarim was missing. So maybe he can try to PPC her too and use his ultimate under tower. This Hikarim still trying to chase and follow this Camille. But he can kill her alone. But maybe with Gwen they can try to do this. And this time enemy team was on the middle lane. And enemy trying to get top on tower. Hikarim was on the top on side. Got Divine Sunderer. So he deals so much damage too. In this town Gwen trying to push lane. So maybe Camille can try to kill this Gwen. She has an ultimate. But she don't wanna jump on this Gwen. Yeah. Cause it's so risky to jump on her. Maybe enemy Hikarim sitting in the bush. Or something another. Oh, this Gwen jumped in. So this Camille thought that enemy just sitting in the bush. It's so strange because this Gwen 062 jumping on you. And look at this, I saw Camille, I mean Hikari was on the top of river. So it was right. Enemy Hikari was on the top of side. But I think this Camille can try to fight against these two people. Because she has so much gold and damage with sustain. But she playing very safe. Not, she don't wanna risk. So maybe okay, it's fine. Her team, so her team has advantage, look at this. So it's not necessary to play very risky. And she don't wanna lose her advantage, cause like I said, if enemy will get some gold, they can try to play for late game, and in late game her team will lose. So it's so important to play very clean, and she don't wanna feed for enemies. Enemy Yukarim, he at bottom side. Poor enemy team was at bottom side, they trying to play for the Drake, and Camille using her teleport to this ward. What she wanna do? Akali also there. So they can try to kill this Kog'Maw, maybe focus best. The best way to go, focus Kog'Maw. Because he gives a lot of damage with his W and this broken Lolo. Oh, this, oh my god, she dodged ultimate from Hikarim, but Misfortune died. So it's not good, and now they're trying to kill this Akali, but Akali used her W. And full enemy team trying to get this dragon. They without Misfortune, so I think it's bad fight. Better to let them this Drake. Yeah, now he shoot back. And now she trying to fight against the enemy. Galio was one-shotted. And Kog'Maw, they focused Kog'Maw with Akali. So it was good raid. And now Camille was popped by Hikarim. It was not good raid. It was strange raid. Why they fought in this place? When enemy just got dragon. Enemy got dragon just, guys, so it's this fight for nothing. If you get them, you get just maximum tower. It's nothing. Enemy just already got enemy tower. Enemy they got dragon. So it's really was strange fight. They without misfortune. They don't first they don't wanna fight. They just went back. And now, after this, they finally just fight it for no reason. And they just gave for enemies a lot of gold. Camille died with another people. So enemy got, look at this now, Gwen got Riftmaker with Arm Guard. Galio got Rocket Belt. Enemy Kog'Maw with Sand, Seal, Boots, and Mail. So it's not good. Now she trying to push top on lane. Enemy Gwen at bottom side. Maybe she can try to catch someone, but no one wanna defense this. Galio under enemy tower. He don't wanna go under. He don't wanna go to try it against Camille. It's so risky for him. Oh, this damage! Whoa! Now I can understand why Galio don't wanna fight and go far his tower. And in this time she pushed this wave, she got also Serena's Hydra with Divine Thunderer and Executioner calling.
You will be where I want you to be.
And also she got Fetch again. So it means she wanna buy Becleaver or Sterak. And in this time enemy Kog'Ma, he killed two people. So it's not a good fight. Kog'Ma for Fortune and Shaco. It's not a good trade for enemies. I mean for her team. Because enemy, like I said, much stronger in late game and every trade for them is very good. They behind, so this broken game system thinks they're behind, they will get more gold for every kill. This comeback system in League of Legends is broken. And now this Galio, he won a lot of time, and this Luz tried to save this Galio, but Lee Sin finally got this Galio. And this Hikarim also so mad, he got this Lee Sin, but he died. And this, oh my god, she survived. No, Camille finally got this Lulu, but she was so close to survive. And in this time Kog'Ma, Camille made triple kill and she can try to fight against this Gwen, but she had a low HP, so she don't wanna risk. She has insane sustain with Hydra and Divine Thunder, so she will sustain a lot of health. Oh, this damage! Oh my god. What do you do, Galleon? Oh, damage was so good, but was not enough, and do sustain from Camille. And this ENQ combo just popped this Galio. And now she got, oh my god, 13 kills. And her team also can know. Yeah, they wanna get this Nashor, but Whiskey calls enemy Hikarim still alive. You can try to steal this Nashor. Camille used your teleport to help our team. Oh, she jumped in on enemies, but there was Kog'Ma. Kog'Ma deals a lot of damage to her and she died. But her team finally got Hikarim. But it was not good trade, cause she has insane streak and enemies. First they just one time they got streak, and this is only died Hikarim for this. And also enemy team can try to get this dragon. They coming for dragon, but listen, you don't wanna defend this. You have smite, maybe you can try to do something. Oh, he don't wanna even use his swords. Enemy just trying to get this dragon. They without jungler, but Lee Sin with smite don't wanna try to steal this. And enemy just got this dragon. So it was strange. And in this time our Camille got Sterak, so it was Sterak. Now she got Sterak and stopwatch. Stopwatch I think for Guardian Angel. But this combo is really so broken. Kog'Ma with Lulu in late game they will literally destroy. And she jumped in on this Kog'Ma. She's so much damage to Kog'Ma, but he survived cause this broken Lulu. Lulu is broken champion. She saved this Kog'Ma and he survived, so this Camille again died for no reason. And this is additional gold for enemies. So guys, it's so high to chance to lose this game. Enemy got so much items. Look at this Kog'Ma with Ahn, Randuin Omen, Runaan Hurricane. Also even Gwen has Riftmaker with stop with Jhonya. So really will be guys so hard to play against them in late game. And this move from Camille was not good. Maybe they should just, for her, just the best way to go to split push. Because she still is very strong at in duels, 1v1. So maybe she can try to split push. She trying to check this place. Enemy guild was there. Enemy bot lane at middle lane. So maybe this guild is alone. Galio at middle lane. So Gwen will go. No, she don't wanna continue her walk. And in this time, this Shaco will die. No. Now this Emil coming. Should I try to catch someone? Oh, but this Galio is his ultimate with Hikarima, and in this time she jumped in on Gwen and she did a lot of damage to the enemies, and now enemy oh my god, this was so good fight. They just come back this fight and now they made ace, just died only Shaco. It was a strange fight, but Akali with Camille, Lee Sin and Ocean dealt a lot of damage to the enemies and they finally got them. It was pretty strange because they should lose this fight. But enemy Hikarim used his ultimate for no reason, just on place, not on enemies. Kog'Maw was one-shotted by enemies, but it was strange, and now she with her team trying to end this game. And they finally got this game, wow. It was so risky. I mean, it was so funny. And I don't know how enemy lost this fight, but they lost. So guys, never surrender, even if you're playing in hard matchup and your team trying to feed. You can win every game, and this game is example how to win game. If you like this video, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Also, you can write a comment about new videos on another champions. And now, have a nice day and goodbye.